I think this year is a little bit different because we haven't been at NAMM. So we thought it's a better idea to be at Synsplex, which is the convention here in Burbank. And this time I'm together with Neusbach. So they are selling us the modules in the US. And there are two things which are important. We are moving into systems, really now fully configured systems. And just to bridge a little bit the wait until Superboost, which is the home run, obviously, we are introducing the sample and hold module, which I guess is not a groundbreaking thing, but we felt that for a complete product line, we need to have something like that. All the other stuff is what we had all the years before, and I think I will just very, very quickly focus on two things you can do with the sample and hold. So what we have is, it's a clock oscillator, which is voltage controlled. Then there are some switches where I can select which control signal or which signal I want to sample. And in addition, there's a lag circuit in it. So what I'm doing at the moment is I'm sampling the white noise, and you see that the output of that one, is going to the oscillator. So what I can do is I think it is a little bit artificial, the setup, because what you usually would do is that you have the static modulation waveforms, which you have the sine or this whatever, the triangle. What you can do with a small amount of that to enhance that a little bit and be a little bit more less predictable. I think it's really a module that helps to animate stuff by itself. It's really not that, you can't use it just alone. The good thing is, it's an LFO which is voltage controllable, and you have a noise source, both a white one and a more dark one.
You have multiple sections, maybe you have the different sections.
Yeah, so it has a noise, which is this, which then runs into the sample and hold, the clock, clocking the sample and hold, and the output of the sample and hold is shaped with the with this one, and then going to the oscillator, or you can go to whatever. So this is obviously very flexible. Yeah, so this is the quote prototype. So we are finalizing, so the guys at home are finalizing the design of it, so it will be available beginning of April. And you can buy it at the usual locations. So Neusbach in the US, Schneidersladen in Germany, and KMR in the UK. So with the systems, we now finally agreed on a certain set of modules we want to have in a system. So what we have is a sequencer, which is 8 tracks, with all a lot of sequencing modules we have. We thought that actually it's a separate trigger sequencer, that's the system. And what we have especially is this setup, which is a two voice synthesizer system. So this is one voice with envelope, this is one voice with envelope. You have, this is our main output mixer, which is fully voltage controlled, and there's a MIDI or USB to CV interface. And because it is a system which we assemble, we can the first time utilize the normalization options the modules have. So this is why you don't see a lot of patch cords. So even in the production model, this will be pre-wired to that. So this is just CV, and this is the output, and these are the gates. So you can work with a two-voice synthesizer pretty much without any patch cords. Obviously, all of this you can override. And I think this is quite for people who want to start from without talking or without thinking about anything, this is a good way to start. Modules are standard modules, so there are no special modules made for that. So you can take out that oscillator and put another one in it, so it's no problem.